In the last movie, you learned about Revit cameras and how they transfer to 3ds Max. In this movie, you do the same with lights. It was mentioned in passing that Revit has two unofficial light types: artificial lights that you add as components, and a daylight system to simulate the sun and the atmosphere. The latter is not manually created, but rather defined in the render settings dialog. Continue working on your scene from the last movie, or use the file named roomwithcams.rvt. Switch to the generic view for a moment, although you'll need the exterior shot at export time. When you export a Revit scene in FBX format, all lights are included in the transfer. In this case, this includes the four artificial lights on the ceiling. Although you don't see it, a daylight system simulating the sun and atmosphere is transferred as well. However, you can decide which of the two types you can enable or disable by default. If you are planning to render a scene by day, you'd want the daylight system enabled and the artificial lights disabled. You want to reverse that process for a night render. The way you decide these settings in Revit is in the Render Settings box. This is done by clicking the Show Rendering Dialog button at the bottom of the screen. Before you do, though, remember that each defined 3D view can have its own set of render settings. So, you want to ensure you're in the view you want to send to 3ds Max before you access the Render Settings dialog. In this case, we'll use the camera exterior shot. Click the Show Rendering dialog button at the bottom of the screen, a dialog appears. This is where you usually go to render a view in Revit, but in this case, you are mostly interested in this section of the dialog. The Scheme drop-down gives you choices between exterior and interior shot settings. Don't waste too much time on the differences. You will inevitably find yourself adjusting many of the parameters in 3ds Max anyway. What you want to take from this drop-down is that a sun-only preset enables the daylight system but disables all artificial lights. Artificial-only does the opposite, enabling all man-made lights and disabling the daylight system. Choose exterior sun only for now. Next, you'll adjust the sun settings. Click the little icon to get to the sun settings options. By default, it is set to a mode named Lighting. This mode translates into a manual mode in 3ds Max, where you control the sun position by moving it around. A more popular way is to work with a geographic location and a date. This can be done by using the Still method. In this case, you don't need to worry too much about location given the nature of this particular project. However, set the time of day to 2 p.m. to see how that transfers to 3ds Max. Click OK when done. Before you export the scene, take note of the background style options. These have an effect on the background you see in 3ds Max at render time. The sky options define the clouds in the atmosphere by using one of four bitmaps. These bitmaps are part of the Autodesk shared library and are installed with most Autodesk applications. The No Clouds option doesn't use any bitmaps, but the other four options use hemispherical images of skies for full effect. Keep the Few Clouds option current for now. Export the scene and name it myroomday.fbx. For those who do not have Revit, a similar file named roomday.fbx has been provided. Now change the time of day again to 10 p.m. and set the scheme to artificial only. Export the scene and this time name it myroomnight.fbx. Again, a similar file named RoomNightFBX has been provided. You now have two similar scenes exported. The only difference relates to how lighting was set up. In the next movie, you import the day scene into 3ds Max to learn how lights were transferred and how to improve the setup.